Good afternoon, Loudoun County Republicans. My name is John Whitbeck, and I am a candidate for the 10th District House of Delegates in Virginia. You know, I wake up in the morning sometimes, and I don't even recognize my country. The Obama agenda is leading us down a path to big problems, and there's really only one thing we can do to fix that, and that's to elect conservative Republicans at every level of government. In times like these of economic uncertainty, each and every one of you and your families need to have the certainty that your taxes are going to stay low. It's impossible for your family or your small business to plan if you're constantly looking over your shoulder to wonder if your taxes are going to be raised by your government. You know, in the last 10 years, per capita, Virginia families are paying 33% more in taxes. But is your commute 33% shorter? Are your schools 33% better? Absolutely not. And that's why we need delegates in Richmond who will hold the line and oppose higher taxes. And I've said before, and I'll say it again, I have taken a pledge, I will oppose all tax increases if I'm elected to the Virginia General Assembly. You know, I'm very wary of politicians who say that they create jobs. Government doesn't create jobs. The private sector creates jobs, and we need to get government out of the way of business. And the reason is because a government's view of business is one that's not compatible with success in business. Government's view is if it moves, you tax it. If it keeps moving, you regulate it. If it stops moving, you subsidize it. And the corollary to that was written in 2008, if it fails, you bail it out. That's government's view of business. It's the wrong view. And if you elect me your delegate to the 10th District, I will go down to Richmond and fight for small businesses and families in Virginia. Now, we also need to make sure that we protect the family. It's the most important segment of our society. And that's why we have to do things like build a culture of life. I am pro-life, period. That means no exceptions. And I know many of you agree with that, and I can tell you, when my wife was pregnant with my two daughters, I marveled at the fact that I was in love with a child that I hadn't even met yet. Think about that. You can't tell me that life does not begin at conception. You can't convince me of that, and that's why I'm pro-life, and I'll be fighting for pro-life policies if I'm elected to the Virginia General Assembly. We also need to make sure that the institution of marriage is protected. History teaches that successful societies honor that institution, and it's important for us to protect it. Families need to be strengthened. You need to be able to make the choice how to educate your children, whether it's public school, private school, homeschool. Bureaucrats in Richmond and bureaucrats in Washington, D.C. ought to not be making the decisions for you how to educate your children. Families ought to do that. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a conservative Republican. That means something to me. Saying you're for lower taxes or less spending or pro-life or pro-Second Amendment are not just slogans that you come up with during election year and discard when you get into office. They mean something. And if you send me down to Richmond, I'm going to prove to each and every one of you that I'm a conservative that will stand and fight for you. Thank you very much. I hope to have your support on August 23rd.
Thank you, John.